This is the cheesiest, creamiest pasta you ever seen on the planet. This is it. No cream, just top quality cheeses. Ladies and gentlemen, the quattro formaggi, the four cheese pasta, it's here on Vincenzo's plate, and I'm going to show you how to make it. Guys, if you are a cheese lover, this is the perfect dish for you. Hi, and welcome to Vincenzo's Plate, the place where you get to learn how to cook amazing Italian food. And this is an amazing cheesy Italian dish made with my favorite creamy cheese. Let's do it. To make pasta ai quattro formaggi, we need to use four special cheeses, okay? So we're gonna choose three creamy cheeses, and you can pick what you want, okay? This is my choice. I picked Italian cheeses. So I've got 50 grams of Gorgonzola cheese. You can use blue cheese. I'm using 50 grams of stracchino cheese. I know it could be difficult to find, so you can replace it with ricotta or any other cheese that you want. I've got 50 grams of mascarpone, really like mascarpone, and three large, even four, tablespoons of pecorino cheese, or it can be parmigiano reggiano. Then the pasta I've chosen is 200 grams of penne rigate. Now you can use any pasta that you want. Gnocchi will be fantastic for this. Tagliatelle will be fantastic. I'm using 200 grams because it's for the two of us, so 100 grams each. It's a very rich pasta, so I think 300 grams is too much. So 200 grams for the two of us is more than enough. Last but not least, we need 80 mils of milk. I'm not a big fan of cooking with milk, but you do need milk for this because these cheeses have milk base. And then we need 1 tablespoon of rock salt for the pasta water and a handful amount of walnuts. Now this pasta is so quick to make, so we're gonna boil the pasta first. So let's put 1 tablespoon of rock salt into boiling water. And now we're gonna boil the penne. This penne needs 11 minutes to cook. Always read the instruction on the packet. See you in 11 minutes. Now guys, before we start cooking the sauce, let's crush the walnuts. We're gonna use these walnuts for the final decoration, okay? Okay, nice and crushed. And they will go on top of our plate at the end of the recipe. All right, now we are ready to make the sauce. So on a very low heat, medium low heat, we don't want this to be high heat, okay? Medium low, we're gonna put the milk in the saucepan, okay? The milk, it's the base of our cheeses. Now, we have two cheeses here to use, okay? First, we're gonna put the gorgonzola and the stracchino inside the milk because they will melt together. And the pecorino and the mascarpone will go at the end, okay? So, let's put this cheese first. Let's go with the gorgonzola. And because this one is a bit harder, just break it. So you help the cheese to melt faster, okay? And stir. Now, very gently and slowly, we want this cheese to melt. Now, if we are going to add the mascarpone and the pecorino right now, what's gonna happen is the pecorino will become stringy, and we don't want to see strings of cheese. We don't want that. We want the cheese to become cream, okay? And the mascarpone doesn't need to be cooked, to be honest. The mascarpone just needs to melt in the pasta. How beautiful. The smell from the gorgonzola. And again, you can use blue cheese. You get the same effect. It's just a beautiful, beautiful smell. Guys, feel free to use any cheese that you love, okay? I'm not doing a reaction video about this. You can use anything that you like, as long as it's a nice, soft cheese. Now, why do we need the milk here? We need the milk because the milk is the base of our cheeses, and the milk will evaporate eventually, but it will help to melt the cheeses. You don't wanna use milk, you can use cooking cream, okay? I think the cooking cream will make it heavier. It's a heavy dish, so it's not really a problem if you make it heavier, but I think milk is a better option. See, the cheese is melted and we are now ready to add the pasta. See, what we have over here, it's beautiful cream. See, it became cream. The milk is not runny anymore. Now it's creamy, you know? It's thanks to the cheese, you know, thanks to the gorgonzola, to the stracchino. The gorgonzola, it's such an important ingredient because it gives you that kick, okay? So the other cheeses that you use, you don't want them to be too strong, okay? The gorgonzola will take over. So just use subtle cheeses that will make it creamy. That's what we want. Our goal is to have a creamy pasta without the cream. Now, our pasta is ready. What we're gonna do is we're gonna get a mug of pasta water full of starch, and this is extremely, extremely important to make the pasta creamier and to combine all the ingredients. Now let's take the pasta out and put it in the sauce. See, the sauce is ready. It's calling the pasta. Pasta, where are you? I'm waiting for you. All right, so let's put the pasta in. Ah, beautiful. Let's quickly stir. Fantastic. Now, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna put the mascarpone cheese in there. Quickly, I wanna melt this for a few seconds. A little bit of pasta water. This is gonna make it creamier. The fire is still on, okay? A little bit of pasta water. The mascarpone is gonna melt. And in about 10 seconds, we are going to remove the pan from the cooktop and we add the Parmigiano or pecorino cheese. This is happiness into a pan. Look at this. Cheesy! All right, this is the time now for the pecorino or Parmigiano. See that? See, well, look what happens now. Look what happens now, okay? I'm gonna add the pecorino everywhere. Super cheesy! And mix. And now it's time to spadellare, mantecare. Let's get the pasta jump. We want this, and this will help to get creamier. Look how creamy this is. Huh? Look how creamy this pasta is. Look at that, look at that, look at that, look at this, look at this. Come on, look at this. Look at the creamy there, see? It's not stringy, it's creamy. It's fantastic. It's ready to be eaten. The pasta wants to be eaten. Come on, come on, come on. Have it now, look at that. Look how pretty, look at this, look at this. A cacio e pepe, a carbonara can dream this cream, can dream it. Look at that, look at that. Guys, this is the 10 minutes creamy pasta that is going to change your life. The four cheeses pasta made just for you. Just for you in 10 minutes. I wanna show you how to make it because this, it's a must. See guys, I just want you to see, look at that. Look how creamy this is. Huh? This is gonna make you so happy. Oh my God, this is gonna make you so happy. Look at this wonderful, wonderful cream. Of course the gorgonzola is taking over, but oh, what a wonderful creation. Simple, easy. This is another example that food should be kept simple. Marvelous, simplicity at its best, yeah. So let's plate this marvelous, marvelous cheesy pasta. Oh, wow, wow, wow. Beautiful, beautiful cheese, yeah. Yum, creamy. This is food porn at its best. Food porn at its best. It's very important that you collect all the sauce in the pan, get everything out, and then we're gonna put it right on top of our pasta. And that will be the how we finish it off before we add the nuts. Guys, the final touch is the crushed walnut. Let me tell you, it's gonna be so yummy. You can use crushed pistachio if you want, crushed macadamia, any nuts that you want. Or if you're allergic, you don't use any nuts. You know, you don't really have to put the nuts, but I think the nuts take it It gives you the extra flavor, the extra kick. And here it is, your full cheeses pasta, made with love. And again, this is my favorite part of the recipe. I'm looking forward to this moment when I get to eat my food. Look how creamy. Let's have it. The gorgonzola kick, the creaminess. I've got the cream stuck in my mouth. I need a glass of white wine to wash my mouth. Why I cook so good? Why my cheesy pasta is the best pasta on YouTube? Huh? You tell me, why is my cheesy pasta the best cheesy pasta online? Huh? This is incredible. The cheese comes out from the penne when you actually try to get them. You can see the cheese coming out from the penne. Guys, I need to keep eating. So thank you so much for watching this episode. I will see you in the next Vincenzo's Plate video recipe. E ora si mangia! Vincenzo's Plate. Oh, it's a cheesy Vincenzo's Plate. Oh, if you're a cheese lover, this is perfect for you.